Today we will be talking about the mesh baker grouper. Our texture baker tutorial showed that the texture baker has a mesh baker grouper component attached. Each texture baker can have multiple mesh baker children. The mesh baker grouper is used to create and control these mesh baker components automatically. Using the mesh baker grouper is optional. If you want, you can ignore it and work directly with each mesh baker component. Why use several mesh bakers? Renderers that are outside the camera frustum can be culled. When meshes are combined, they can no longer be individually culled. We only want to combine meshes that are usually on screen together. If groups of meshes are widely separated, then we usually want to use separate mesh bakers for each group. First, let's show you the general workflow. Here's an example scene of an asteroid field with around 1,300 asteroid objects. We've already added these objects to a texture baker and created an atlas. See our previous tutorial for learning the workflow for this. Now we want to combine the meshes, but we don't want to combine everything in the scene into a single combined mesh. If we did, anything off camera would never be culled. Set the cluster type to grid, adjust the size of the cells, and click Generate Bakers. Now the asteroids have been grouped into 345 mesh bakers. We can bake them all at once by pressing the Bake All Child Mesh Bakers button. The scene now contains 345 combined meshes arranged into a 3D grid. We can be a little bit more efficient with our clustering, since right now each cluster only has 5 or 6 asteroids. If we don't like the grid size, we can recreate and rebake the mesh bakers easily by deleting the bakers and combined meshes, adjusting the cell sizes, and rebaking. The grouper has several different clustering options: None, Grid, Pie, and Agglomerative. Cluster type None does no clustering. Everything is combined into a single mesh. The grid divides the scene into boxes and combines the meshes in each box. We just showed how this works. Pie lets us define an origin, axis, and number of segments. The scene will be divided into pie-shaped slices. This is useful if you're working with a stationary camera that can rotate, for example a turret. The agglomerative cluster type is great for general purpose grouping. The algorithm tries to find clusters in the scene. If you press click to build clusters, a visual aid will appear in the scene view. This will update as you move the distance slider around, making it easier to see how many groups you have and how big they are. When things look about right, click Generate Bakers. Remember that Unity has two sizes of meshes. The smaller meshes are slightly faster. Don't worry if surpassing the 64,000 vertices limit is unavoidable. In that case, Mesh Baker will automatically use a multi-mesh baker instead of a mesh baker to split the combined meshes until they fit under the limit. The Mesh Baker grouper has a few additional settings. Group by lightmap index is fairly self-explanatory. Objects sharing a lightmap index will be grouped together. Group by LOD level can be used if your source objects use an LOD group. A baker will be created for each LOD level. You can build a new LOD group from these combined meshes. This approach only works well if the source meshes are very close together. There is little benefit to combining meshes that only have one renderer. Unchecking the Include Cells with Only One Renderer box will ignore any groups with only one object. The Mesh Baker grouper also has powerful bake into prefab abilities. Auto-generate prefabs will generate a prefab for each mesh baker and therefore each group. Generated prefabs will be saved in the prefab output folder. We recommend checking out the video on tools for adding objects. These tools provide a very fast workflow for finding all combinable objects, which can then be atlased, grouped, and baked. The link is in the description. Mesh Baker is available on the Unity Asset Store. You can also visit us at digitalopus.ca for more resources and tips for using Mesh Baker.